This is experiment 9 on solution formation and characteristics. Let's have a look at the pre-lab review page. First question deals with safety alerts. Remember to look for the triangle icons. Number 2, specific disposal directions. Look for the garbage can icons. There's lots of room here, so that's your hint that there'll be some of those. And the rest of these questions are pretty straightforward. I don't think you'll have any difficulty. Let's look at the data and report page. In this experiment, you'll be judging whether or not solids and liquids form solutions. If it's a solid and forms a solution, or a liquid for that matter, everything appears to disappear. You see a uniform solution. But if something is insoluble, if it's a solid, chances are it's on the bottom of the test tube. If it's a liquid that's insoluble, you'll see two layers. So in each of these parts, look to see if solubility has occurred or if you have a solid sitting on the bottom. Part B deals with the solubility and dissociation of chlorine-containing solutes. These are the substances that we're going to try to dissolve. Each of them have chlorine somewhere within the structure, and we'll be looking at their solubility. If it appears to dissolve, then you'd mark it with a plus. If it doesn't dissolve, you'd use a minus. And once again, look for solids on the bottom of the test tube, or if it's a liquid, look for two layers. If you see those, then it hasn't dissolved. If you just see a uniform solution, then it has dissolved. So each of these substances in this first column, you'll mark with a plus or minus. Then you'll test using silver ion for the presence of chloride. If something dissolves and produces chloride ion, it'll react with silver and you'll get a white precipitate. If you see that white precipitate, mark it with a plus. So here too in this column, you'll use plus and minus. But there's one caveat, and that is if you have a minus on this side, then you won't test for the silver ion. In other words, it's got to dissolve before you have any chance of testing with the silver ion. In table 9.4 is the report part. So again, in this first column, you'll mark everything with a plus or minus. If it dissolves, use a plus. If it doesn't dissolve, use a minus. And for those substances that have dissolved, where you've indicated a plus, then you can, over here, use a plus or minus to indicate whether it dissociated and produced chloride ion. So if one of these things on the left doesn't dissolve, you'll have a blank over on the right-hand side. Don't let that confuse you. Each of the parts of the experiment are pretty much like that. Part C deals with the solubility and dissociation of OH-containing solutes. OH, you know, is a base, and so we're using pH to decide whether OH is present or not. First column, use a plus or minus to indicate whether it dissolves or not. In the second column, for those substances that have dissolved, indicate their pH. So if you have a negative here, you won't have any pH data in the right-hand side. Same thing is true in the report part. In the first column, indicate a plus or minus, depending on its solubility. In the second column, indicate with a plus those that have dissociated and produced OH. And again, if you didn't have a plus here, this column will just be blank in that particular spot. Part D, the solubility and dissociation of acids. Some of these are liquids, some are solids. Solubility, plus or minus. And then for those that are plus, you'll have pH data and indicate that. Same thing in the report, plus or minus for solubility. For those that dissolve and you have a plus, indicate the acid strength over here. And part E, the influence of solvent and solute on solubility. We're looking at two substances, the solubility in water and the solubility in toluene. And I'm going to skip down to this little statement at the bottom. You know that water is polar. Toluene is nonpolar. And this is a general rule of thumb for solubility. Like dissolves like. Or sometimes we just use one word. Like likes like. And what we mean by this is that polar substances, like water, like other polar things and dissolve them well. But they don't like nonpolar things. Then if I talk about nonpolar things, nonpolar likes nonpolar. So we can tell if something dissolves in water, then that tends to indicate that it's polar. If something dissolves in toluene, that indicates that it's nonpolar. And you, over here in the report part, you'll use the letter P for polar and N for nonpolar based upon the solubility data back here. So that's a fun little part of the experiment. It's just using something quite simple, a solvent, we can tell whether a substance is polar or nonpolar. Questions at the end of the chapter. Some of these are challenging. Here's a little tip for number three that'll help you a little bit. Question three is focused around gasoline, and I just want you to know that typically small amounts of water are found in some gasoline. And that completes the experiment. So I hope you've enjoyed it. Remember to send me an email if I can be of help.